The first time you arrive at Heligan, you have a huge sense of anticipation. And then you walk in and you step back in time.
There were beautiful sections that were really well tended and looked after. But then you walk down into the woodlands areas and into the jungle areas, and there was just wilderness and wildness as well. So it was a lovely combination and contrast of wild and formal.
After the First World War, it just basically went into rack and ruin. The gardens just completely were absorbed by the landscape. The story changed here when that little bit of wall was discovered. That is part of the magic as you walk around. You just look at it and shake your head in wonder and think, how could it be that, 30 years ago, this was just overgrown wilderness? It's incredible. I think if the original owners and designers of Heligan walked around it now, they would be so proud. They'd look at it and think, wow. They wouldn't realise it had vanished in between, has been brought back to life. And that's a monument to the people who work it today.
This is Courage. He's our Shire horse. He's 6 years old now. Come on!
But it's also a monument to graft and love and the amount of energy and attention that was put in to turning it into this absolutely miraculous place that you visit nowadays. Commercial pressures push towards more sort of standard breeds, but these breeds are so, so important because they're part of the heritage and history of the region as much as the buildings are or anything else is. Here we go, and the back leg goes. Oh, there we go. Oh, that's the spot. That is the spot. That's perfect. I really like it when you do that.
The garden's very much based around a point in time, the end of the 19th century, early 20th century. And it's these skills that we really nurture. So everything in the productive gardens is done by hand, following traditional methods.
Over the past few decades, at least half a century, we've managed to grow out all the good benefits, all the nutrients and the minerals and the vitamins, and all the really good stuff out of our fruit and vegetables. But it's critical now to start getting that back.
I'm getting an overwhelming urge to dig.
When I open it, it's trying to smell, because it should smell like pineapples. You should
feel like the jungle.
This is the jungle smell.
Wow,
that is the
humid.
Jungle.
Luna.
Oh yeah, that smells like tropical rainforest. It's incredible.
If you think about the planets moving around the sun, it's a similar sort of thing, that everything moves by rotation. So it's like some grand ballet is going on here with the soil.
Not only the size is remarkable of these huge rhododendron bushes, but the colours are just absolutely gorgeous. Wherever you look, there's layers upon layers of absolutely stunning, stunning flowers.
The origin of so many of these incredible rhododendrons that we have here go back to the middle of the 19th century and an incredibly important botanist and plant collector called Sir Joseph Hooker. The rhododendrons that we've seen all through the gardens take us straight back to that moment, and they're a really important part, not just of our national heritage, but of international heritage.
From that tiny seed, there is the most magnificent giant plant that will hopefully be here and will keep blooming like it does for another 100 years.
Over the course of the day, we walked 10 and a half kilometres as a family, through valleys and over road bridges.
You're right there, Dom. That's the end. We're nearly there. We're nearly there.
That is one trusting dog.
We came to Heligan expecting a good day out, and what we got was an absolutely magical experience.